training, reject the physically fit merely because of height or build. What could there be left for someone unable to move? But her determination to lead a creative life stays with her to this day.
Glamorous as possible.
Incredibly, this morning, she's on her way to give a dancing lesson.
Morning, Elizabeth.
Morning.
Off to work?
Yes, busy day.
Through pupils like Karen, Elizabeth has returned to the dance. Elizabeth is welcomed by one of her team of helpers. Without them, her hectic creative life would be impossible. Therefore, one of her most important tasks is working out the weekly rota of helpers and the drivers for the ambulance she bought to give her even greater freedom. But she depends not only on human helpers. Like many disabled people, she makes full use of electronic gadgetry.
Oh, this morning?
Yes. Are they going to take on straight off, Karen?
By sucking or blowing a sequence of numbers, Elizabeth's patient-operated selector mechanism, known as possum, enables her to do many things for herself, such as adjust the room temperature, switch on television, and open the door. Thanks to Possum, she can also use the telephone, and her day usually begins with several business calls. Today, the first call is to her engineer, Doug Adams.
68623.
Hello, Doug. It's Elizabeth.
Oh, hello, Elizabeth.
I'm awfully sorry to bother you, but the easel seems to have got a bit stuck.
Oh, does it? What happens?
Can I just discuss what paintings you want for this exhibition?
Well, I suppose your ballet scene.
Elizabeth's life started anew when she learned to paint with a brush held in her mouth. She chose ballet scenes, which proved so popular that eventually she earned enough to lead an independent life again and to set up her own dance studio.
Hello, Elizabeth. Hang on, Karen, shan't be sick. Mr. Hines, I've just got to speak to Karen. Come in.
One of her first pupils was Karen Perry.
Righto, bye-bye. Hello, Karen.
You're not late, dear.
Will you change in the little room? The heat's on. Mm-hmm. Don't be long. Okay, bye-bye. Wendy, could you load the tape for me, please? It's the one in the yellow box.
The flexibility of Elizabeth's possum controlled tape recorder gives her the same freedom to use music as any other ballet mistress.
Karen, we'll just do a short bar before you do your variation, just to warm you up. Down. Stretch your knees. Don't roll your ankles, will you?
I first started having lessons with Elizabeth when I was 10. Before then, I had auditioned for the Junior Royal Ballet School and had been refused. So I went to train with Elizabeth. And after 6 years, I decided to audition again. And so I was accepted. I think they were probably intrigued how I'd managed to learn from her despite a disability. When I've been performing badly, not dancing well and responding to what she wants, wasting her time, she sent me out of the room and said, go home.
Fine. Yes, that's better, Karen. Shoulder better. All right, are you warm enough here?
I've thought of giving up many times, but I knew that she had something special.
All right. Ready? Go.
Elizabeth's own ballet group began after she was asked to arrange a dance sequence for a service in Chelmsford Cathedral. She learned that her new vocation was liturgical dancing, and she formed the Chelmsford Dancers, who have now performed in churches, cathedrals, and abbeys throughout Britain, even inside prison. And her interpretations have given a new depth of meaning to Christian worship. But she does not confine herself to the religious.
Lift your ribs. Straight into the next one.
Like a Degas painting in movement, the dancers express the beauty and the range of Elizabeth's
to imagine it's an enormous auditorium. Look, follow your hands through. Follow your eye line. Breathe in. Breathe in hard. Now bring our head into it. A deep chest there. Behind you. Follow your top arm. Now
swift one, Anne. Hold it together. Now breathe before you go down. Breathe.
Line of four. As you, yes, Sheila was out of line.
Yes.
Kneel down. Right, now a big breath as you go down, up and down. Now on this port de bras, come forward, over and over. Now Sue and Karen have been going backwards. You shouldn't, you'd all be coming forward. Go on, reach forward, forward. Now come up. You'll find you're more in a line there. Up, straight your arms, higher. Right, now stop dead. Sheila, get into line.
Doug Adams, a consultant engineer, invented Elizabeth's motorized easel. When overhauling the equipment, he finds it strangely free from difficulty.
I often need a little piece to fit in with the job I'm doing. And I've got a box of bits and pieces that I've collected over the years, and I sometimes find the bit I want. When I'm doing a job for Elizabeth, I know I'm going to find it. It's the right size and the right bore, and or has the right number of teeth to fit in with the gear and so on. It's quite a remarkable thing, but I know that the bit I want is in that box. And I find it. Elizabeth has some movement in the fingers and thumb of her right hand, and I designed the easel to be controlled by micro switches set in a plastic cast made by her dentist.
When Elizabeth first tried to paint, it seemed an impossibility. Holding the brush in her mouth, it was to be 9 weary months before she was able to load it with paint. At a hospital in Dover, one who tried to help was professional artist Rosemary Howard.
And I hear you've got some paintings that you're having for the exhibition.
The thing that impressed me the most was her determination to paint, starting out with no hands. It's the most vital piece of equipment that an artist needs, and with her, she's just got to manage with her mouth. Often, she'd do a very nice picture, perhaps spend half an afternoon on it, and then all of a sudden her mouth muscles probably would get tired and the brush would just slither down the paper and make a dreadful jagged lump of paint, like a painted scream, really. She was wonderful. She never complained about it. Often we had hoots of laughter, in fact, when she had her disasters, as she called them.
Well, I've got four movements, you know, my thumb.
Mm-hmm.
That takes it for the left. And that takes it for the right. That's fairly logical.
Yes.
This is the illogical one. Because it goes up and the easel goes down. That's the only movement I've got in my hand.
I like this one, Elizabeth.
Do you?
Yes. Very much. Nice light touch you've got on it.
I think it's sometimes...
And you're eliminating the detail much better, aren't you, than you used to?
I rather miss your guidance.
Well, I think that's lovely. Yeah. Lots of other people do pictures of ballerinas, you know, they're very pretty, but they're not balletical like Elizabeth's pictures are. Hers are technically